lecture, man is always ready. Like, bolo kab aana hai. I said, you know, how about 1.5 hours or 3 hours? 3 hours for us. So let me introduce him as a co-faculty and a co-friend of Bombay University. This is very important. I've been telling you that we've got so many stalwarts within Bombay University. And we're discussing now over there in my room also, saying that we are an undervalued brand. So remember that discussion about Bombay University going abroad.
Yes.
And setting up campuses and all. We're discussing on that also, saying that we've got so much knowledge, the world is waiting for us. And Srini sir actually comes from a kind of a discipline of study which has been spoken about in the whole world, and that is management. Correct? So IIMs have made it big. The biggest CEOs of the biggest companies are from India. He does teach in quite a few management institutes, not only in Bombay University but even IIMs, traveling also abroad. So let me quickly give you a formal introduction about Srini sir. So, Dr. Srinivasan is currently with the Jamnalal Bajaj Institute of Management Studies, where he is an associate professor, and the department is Management Studies. And again, I tell you, part of the same Bombay University, but we are working towards making it an autonomous institution by itself, which will have its own freedom. Like, we are an autonomous school, right? We have the decision how to make it, etc. We have the advantage of being an autonomous body within Bombay University. But we still need to have the experience of Jamnalal Bajaj, because Jamnalal Bajaj is the first management institution in Bombay.
President, even in along with IIM, they started in 65.
So we have that
experience there.
Exactly. And there are a lot of stalwarts from Jamnalal Bajaj who made it very big. So when I hand it over to him, before he starts the subject, I think we should talk a little bit more about Jamnalal Bajaj. Like, I keep speaking about Bombay University, right? Brand building. So he's from Jamnalal Bajaj. Now look at the kind of work that he's doing. I always get impressed, because every time we meet, we are talking about aage kya karna hai. Okay, he holds a PhD degree in management from our own university. His areas of interest are including strategic management, which we'll be taking today, marketing strategies, marketing and retail shoppers' behavior. He has more than 18 years of experience in the corporate world and the academics. He is a member of the advisory board of the Journal of Business Retail and Marketing Business Management, Journal of Developmental Research. He is editor-in-chief of Journal of Indian Retail. He has received many awards and recognition for his academic excellence from Higher Education Forum, Rajiv Gandhi Award from the Indian Solidarity Council. So awards, rewards, knowledge, all full of bhara hua hai.
But front of Radha is nothing.
He's also authored 3 books, and in academics, authoring books is very essential. Namely, Mall Management. He's a retail expert for all those people who are interested in the retail future. He's the advisor for you. Strategic Retail Management and Cases in Retail Management. He has published many articles, research papers, case studies in national and international journals, magazines and newspapers of repute. His recent case study has published in AV publication. He is consulted by many organizations in the area of strategic marketing and retail strategies. He has already sent me a case study, which Chetan, don't mind, just take it from me so that you students can analyze it. I'm going to give the complete, how the structuring of the whole lecture has to be done from him. But I already told Srini sir, if you want to take it to the next level, and of course Srini sir gave us time, so we like to repeat this session with a different audience also. Because I'm telling you, today onwards I'll be introducing you to some really leadership experts, and they're not leadership experts as academicians, they actually advise companies and been helping out a lot of people. One last thing before I hand it over is that I discovered this, I did not know this. I knew you are from Tamil Nadu, but he's actually from Kanchipuram. How many of you heard about Kanchipuram? I mean, Kanchipuram is known for many things, including the Kanchipuram silk. Sari. But also, it's a very culturally developed place. And a lot of people from Kanchipuram, which are a place in Tamil Nadu, have made it very big. It's very deeply spiritually associated. And that makes him different from the others, because when we talk about ethics and values, it's very different. But at the same time, he's a I like his financial understanding. I mean, so ethics and values and finance. Like, we just are doing a paper on finance from Arthashastra.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to leave it over here. But I'm so happy that every time we meet first as friends, and we talk about what we can do better in Bombay University and take it abroad. Thank you, Srini sir.
Thank you, sir. One thing I always find it's my pleasure to be here. Thanks to Dr. Radha, because his career growth, if you see his contribution towards you know, is phenomenal. And the way energy what he gets with the positive vibration what he creates within the group. I used to meet a couple of times when with Dr. Guru used to come because we strongly followed him, you know. And his amazing work he is doing it. And we are doing it in a different way, but still I feel there is a long way to go, right? And I do walk, it's okay. It's difficult to see camera because that, you know, it's the first lecture, I thought I normally do extempo. When he called yesterday, I said, okay, I'll try to come today because little bit occupied with this, you know, that Mumbai University works, traveling quietly, you know. I do teach in a couple of IIMs and DT to teach. And he said yesterday, why don't you do something on strategy and leadership and management, you know, because this works something very frequent, you know. I'm basically an academician. If I go something basics, you have to sincere apologies, even though you come from rich experience, I go through basics, right? So I will take 5 minutes. Entire my session plan is 3 hours with a break of 10-15 minutes. I'm sure it's very early to stage to ask, what do you understand the word management apparently? Then I'll come into different type of management. In fact, we are discussing, I'd like to learn. Probably I wish to sit in the other side and try to learn because what is what is doing from this particular department, it has huge phenomenal skyrocketing scope in near future. Probably this is a niche area where we are reinventing our needs, we have not created something new. For example, if Radha is doing something, he has not created something. He is reinventing what is there existing. That is what world would like to know. What is happening here, because we already lost this legacy. Probably this legacy should know to everyone, it is proved and tested that these are the best practices. Right? So we'd like to know about what is the management. What do you like to, what is your understanding about the word management? I'm sure you must be practicing it with a rich experience. Yeah.
Organize, control, to perform.
Okay. Before getting into that, I need a suggestion. What type of session you are expecting me for the 3 hours? Do you have something in your mind? Because I do teach in multiple areas. Yesterday I was there in Gadrej for almost doing 6 hours training, you know. And tell me what is there in your mind? How do you like to engage me for 3 hours?
We are open.
Interactive session?
Okay, interactive. Then what else?
More concerned with author.
More concerned with?
Finance. How to?
No, we will get into the later the part. Finance is not my core area. Unfortunately, I am a marketing strategy guy. Right? And, but it is required. Without numbers, we can't do that. But still, I will discuss from a different perspective if the time comes later. Because only 3 hours, we can give only a flavor. No? We can't able to give it to them. Probably we will get today the aroma from the perspective, but not the entire stuff. Yeah.
Practical approach.
Fabulous. So now, interactive, yes. That means you have to speak. And second, practical, obviously we will try to interact, we will try to see what we can able to do. Yeah? Okay. Sir, you said management is something, is all about planning, organizing, right?
Controlling.
Yeah, that's what even every book talks about, even that entry file also talks about, you know. All the 14 principles, starting from planning to escape B cups. We'll keep it as empty. Fabulous. What else? Because I feel, no, because we're all doing the management, Indian management, I thought it is not there in my, but anyway, there's strategic management. Management is there in every word. Today, if you talk about Chanakya principles, there is a management skills. Financial management, if you want to know, there is a management attention. Always the word will be suffixed with the management. Why it is? I remove the word management, learn only finance. No? Why do you like financial management? Why you want to learn strategic management? Why you want to know Arthasastra management? Learn only Arthasastra. No? Why do you like management into this?
It's an art.
It's an art. I'm not asking the question, it's an example question it is. Management is an art or science. That is an exam killing. Tell me what reality in the classroom, what is management is all about?
It's supposed to try in a very simple way, like as a homemaker or a like at home. So I know that there is a event hone wala, so then I will think, okay, iske liye what do I want, ye chahiye, wo chahiye, this is what I am going to prepare, this is what I will get, so these people like this. So then I have to make 5 things, so in those 5 things, what are the ingredients I will like. So I manage the entire thing or suppose sab puri taiyari karke
reaching the goal, organizing,
I appreciate
reaching the goal in a proper, reaching the goal in a proper manner.
Reaching the goal in a proper manner is a management. What else? Everybody's answer right now. Really, sir, I'll appreciate you. Planning to control, that's what the management is all about. As you said, management is an art. And madam said, whatever I have, certain things I have to focus. I have certain objectives. I want to achieve that objectives. I have certain priority. And I have to do all it, right?
Yeah.
Anything else?
Process.
Getting your team to perform.
Pardon?
Getting your team to perform.
Getting your team to perform.
Can you elaborate a little bit? Because I also read this definition some, I don't know who is the author who has written it. If I could be able to find that fellow, I'll slap that guy. But not your answer. No, I'll tell you answer this. Your answer is refined. You know, 90% people used to say management is art of getting things done from others.
Yes.
I don't know who has written that's a ridiculous definition. Even if we say no layman language, I'm putting layman language, don't take it authentic lecture. Even if you become a successful father, you can't say no work done from others. It can't appreciate it. It is one is, you know, you have to take the responsibility. You have to put an effort, whatever it is. Yeah, I'm giving layman example from the understanding sake. These are the definition. I don't know really who has written a book and corrupted the mind. And in learning stage, we should know numbers without taking owners, without taking. In fact, history says, I never say, don't take it. I never take ownership on me. I never said this. History says. Today, if we talk about, I'll give you the example also in upcoming. Maybe any other definition.
It is what you want to do, how you want to do, when you want to do.
Where you want to do, whom you want to do, all the WHs. Okay, fabulous. What else? These are all the things I really appreciate. What else? Yeah.
Optimal utilization of men, matters, methods.
Fabulous. Utilizing the resources. Yeah, that's right. In fact, she said, I have 5 priorities. Somebody said, I have certain objectives to do. You have to integrate that, right? And when you are doing the work, you have to do in a different perspective, right? And how do you want to use your resources?
Optimal
resources. How?
Best
use efficiently.
Fabulous. What's your name? Very
attractive. Very attractive. Happy to hear that.
Yeah.
Dinesh.
Fabulous. Effectively, efficiently. Yeah?
Yeah.
Sorry, you only said incorrect. So, see, even if you said any wrong answer, I never say you said a bullshit answer, throw out of the class. Between you and that, this is a classroom, right? Neither I'm not a full time faculty, do you attendance or internal? It's only matured, internal, you know, seasoned crowd it is. Right? Tell me the difference between these both, sir. What is the difference between efficiency and effectiveness? Because really, you know, the word is what we are playing in English, you know, it's a fabulous language. I accommodate.
Efficiency is about the optimum.
Okay.
Utilization of energy, effort,
knowledge. Okay. Okay. What is effectiveness then?
Get results.
So, for example, it's a very rock. Now you understood, no? Sir, to talk to this management, they're spending almost half an hour. We are doing management course. We don't know what is the management, the basic crossroads. From your understanding, right? Because you know everyone textbook definition, I really appreciate that, but doesn't help you course. Yes, sir.
Efficiency is doing the right things. Effectiveness is doing the right things. Efficiency is getting maximum output.
Doing things right. Yeah, correct. In fact, that's not the
maximum output.
Yeah, doing things right, doing right things. There is a difference. And 90% people, we don't know the difference, but still we use it. That's why the marketing guys, we take advantage out of that. I tell you the later the part. 90% people in the class doesn't know the difference between biscuit versus cookies. If I ask you the difference, you will give your own definition. Biscuit and cookies. If I ask you the difference between biscuit and cookies, you will get the answer, you will get shock of your life.
What?
Would you like to know that?
Please, sir.
What is the difference between biscuit and cookies? No, I am not going to tell you, only tell you. Don't expect me to tell. But I will tell you the end of the day, the outcome.
Same.
No.
For example, I'll come back to that after 5 minutes. First, I'll complete the management, then I'll come to the dinner because efficiency and effectiveness.
It's same.
Right? You said effectiveness and efficiency, doing right things versus doing right things. End of the day, there is a resource. You should have some objectives. And end of the day, what management says? Utilizing your resources, optimum. That's what madam said, right? Manat, come, return jada. Manat tamare, bachat aapkai. Demand bolte na? Like that, we have to tell, I put less effort, would like to take more return, right? For doing, I would like to do a small exercise. Very tough exercise, I'll see I'm an academician, right? I'm proud to say I'm an academician. The reason is I behave like an academician, right? I'll tell you one exercise. For doing this exercise, we require paper, pen and knowledge. We have all this stuff. So far, this is resources. I have certain objectives, what we are going to do. That objective will give output also. Somebody said, no, the process, output, that also will be there. Don't copy it. Right? Ready? Paper and pen knowledge? Don't copy. Please do that. Yeah?
so meticulous. She write exercise also. Right. In a rectangle, write a word manageable.
Sorry?
In a rectangle, write a word manageable. Exercise is done. In a rectangle, write a word management. I have to tell you, sir, rectangle means, no, I go to IIMs to teach. It's not to check your knowledge. Sometimes we do mistake out of the mind. Rectangle means, you know, more or less this is a rectangle. If the all shape is as, it's a square. Because triangle is different. It happens. See, you are not one, sir, you will get many people, don't worry. Better also better attempt to write a triangle. That is square, huh? What you are doing. This is not a square. Better you are doing this thing. Now, everybody has done. I'd like to see who has done that. Fabulous. Can you see the guys who have done next to them, not to me? Just check. How many people have done? Right? You get a company, madam also did here. There are many people doing a triangle here. Triangle is out of a picture, they can family planning. We have to train no more. This is a rectangle. Okay.
The paper itself is rectangle.
No, I'll come back to this, sir. You are intelligent guy. You are a rectangle. Boss, why don't you give one talia? It happens, all the five fingers are not same, somebody should be intelligent in the class. Otherwise, we can teach to everybody, no? And if everybody is intelligent, there is no role of faculty also. Right? We'll come here, we have to teach something. So, everybody should have a, it is a common everywhere. Right? Now you tell me, everybody has done this exercise. Sir, what you have done? Because you said about efficiency and effectiveness, right? This is efficient and effective. This is efficient and effective, whatever you have done. Aapla management definition bola, aapila bata, main kuch nahi bola.
Neither efficient nor
effective. Impossible. It should be something.
Interpretation of what you said.
But what is it? Can you repeat my question? I don't want to answer.
You said in a rectangle.
No, repeat my question. Can you repeat my question? I don't want to answer. In most of my lecture, I never ask answer. I ask them only my student to repeat my question. If repeat the question itself is great.
Management in a rectangle.
Pardon?
So you write management in a rectangle.
Okay.
In a rectangle. In a rectangle.
Write a rectangle. I never ask them to write a rectangle. I say, sir, why you did? Honestly, got confusion by drawing rectangle, triangle, square. You did the work which I never asked to do. Probably I'll appreciate, sir. What's your name, sir?
Chetan Gandhi. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see the basic grassroots definition. Whatever you said, management says. Whatever definition you said, everything is right. But that is not expected to do that. Probably you can say, no, your paper is the only thing you have to say what? You have to use your resources less and get maximum return. And what my definition said was in a rectangle, write about management. You don't need to worry about that. Yes, your notebook, your paper, your pen. If you ask me, sir, how can I do it better? Your notebook, only thing. Aisa kar do. This corner now become rectangle. You don't need to draw a rectangle. Write about management here. So that you can use this for. Right, whatever you want, write two pages also. Nobody stopped doing it. You call it to the conclusion, whether you have to draw a triangle or rectangle or square. Many people did. That is part of management. These are all things, whatever you did, efficient, except that Chatur did. So this is the difference between doing right things versus doing things right. But believe me guys, I think I can take authority on this class. None of any foreigner have a guts, rights to come and teach us what is management. I can tell you open challenge. The reason is simple. You tell me today whatever the technology, whichever the product, today if you want to make any, take a hypothetical example, today you want to construct world class building, very tallest building. To construct the building, what are the things do you require? First thing people say cement, steel, computers, whatever you need, without IOT, elevator, electricity, power. Without that, can you able to make it? Can you able to make it? This is the basic thing. And even if you construct world class, the shelf life of the product, of the building will be 100 years or 200 years.
not more than that. Not, none of the people in the world can say my building will never last for 1000 years. There will be 100 years I'll be carrying. उसके बाद मुझे मालूम नहीं मैं करता हूँ अलग बात वॉट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड टूडे स्टील सीमेंट कंप्यूटर्स ऑटो कैड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी हाई एंड एलिवेटर्स दिस आर रिक्वायर्ड राइट नथिंग नथिंग वॉज देयर 2000 इयर्स बिफोर वॉट एवर वी डिड इवन टूडे आई डोंट नीड टू टॉक अबाउट एनीथिंग हाइपोथेटिकल गो एंड सी द टेंपल्स विच इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड फ्यू थाउजेंड इयर्स बिफोर विदाउट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विदाउट पेपर Without pen, whatever they done, still it is surviving for 2000 years. Even today you can't do it. Do you think without management skill they have done? Probably they may not have a high-end, even today if you call carpenter, that fellow comes, very royal guys. Today they come with high-end machines, they use our plug-and-play system, electricity, they cut everything, not with the axe. Manual karte nahi, they bring the machine, they use your electricity, still they charge 300 rupees. Just imagine how they must be done. Even without management scheme, without planning, without organization. What is management is all about? This is the textbook definition. Whatever you have written, I'll appreciate. This is for your understanding. I'm sure near future, you never forget this exercise ever in your life. Whenever you see Payagal, remember Rajiv Gandhi. You can see this again, which is Payagal Shikhar. Right? But, what is management is all about? What is management? Do you think the temples which is constructed few thousand years before, do you think without management skill we have done? Not only temples, even if you go to some extreme, you know, many things. I can give an example because one of the world class example. Okay, what else?
Taj Mahal.
Taj Mahal. Let's do maybe 2 or 3 days old, sir. Go to Tanjore temple. Not even 4 feet. Still today the temple single stone is having few thousand tons. In fact, Tanjore temple, yes. The late Tanjore, it's called Peri temple, and the Nandi, and if you see how they constructed, even today it can't be a miracle. If you go to have Hampi, Alaped, Hospet, and I wish you should go all these places, you'll come to know the reality of Indian architect technology. We talk about Mughals has done great. No. They have done good work by killing others, by saying that they become a good. But if you see how this reality has happened, it's not done overnight. What is management is all about? What is management is all about? Is it a people is a management? If there is no Rajaraja Chola or maybe XYZ Krishna Devaraya, there is no temples in Tamil Nadu. So because of people, can we call as a management? I'm going to the next question. See, I don't mind to get into strategy. Yesterday when he said, I said definitely I'll get into strategy. I thought we'll discuss a little bit about basic management. Because strategic management is analyzed with everything. If we are not comfortable with the management from our own school of thoughts, we can't able to understand further. Right? Yeah. Is it a people is a management? Because that's what today we talk about strategic leadership, people management. If there is no Krishna Devaraya, there is no temples in South, most other temples. Or maybe little bit Pallavas. Credit goes to 1 or 2. So is it management is all about people? Can we call it? If there is no Raja, there is no course of this leadership course. Can we call this as a management? Even can we call as a management Kumbh Mela, one of the highly best event in the world. Nobody do PR or SME or SMO. Automatically people assembles. How they assemble, how they come, how they organize, where they stay, where they will go. Even today, Howard came to understand it. They said, boss, there is no diseases were spread, even though it's highly polluted, everything people are coming and going, but it's one of the highly successful organization. How it is organized, who is organizing, is there any committee as that? Nobody knows. Is it called event as a management? Hey, I'm asking question, you have to tell me the answer. You only said, sir, we want interactive lecture. I'm only asking question.
Yes.
No, what yes? Is it called management? Yes. Event is a management or people is a management. What is management? Today we talk about Tirupati organization, one of the best organization. Crores of people comes, few thousand crores amount is collected. Is it called, that is a great management? Or Shiridi or Shiddi like so called. What is management? Is it a place? Or some place has some unique advantage, right? Darjeeling, like. Is it a place, can we call it as a management? Because of place, that area has become a global. Can we call place as a management? Because every place has some uniqueness, you can even replicate. Why people all the way go to XYZ to see the place, right? And most of the country is built because of the location. Why people go to Swiss and France? Because of great infrastructure? No, they like the greenery. why North is attracting more and Kerala is attracting more? Because of it has some natural climatic competitive advantage which other states may not be having. Right? Why everybody IT companies getting into Bangalore and Pune? Because of the climatic condition, relatively it is better. Why people are exiting from Gujarat? Because still they found that IT is not ideally suitable because of the earthquake. So can you call place as a management? In fact, I asked multiple questions, you have to try to give an answer. What is management is all about?
It's about execution.
Execution, okay.
Logically.
If there is no money, there is no reliance. So can you call people as a management? If there is no Tata, there is no Tata Group. But today it is proved, no? What Tamaran can able to run a Tata Group. So people is not a... Now I'll give you the answers now. People is not a management. Don't think it. Well, it's big. If there is no Ambani, somebody will run the company. Don't worry about it. Sometimes people also worry, you know, when R.D. Burman dies, or even that Bollywood lost a great musician. There will be no songs will come near for you. Also got some time, no? If there is no Iliraja, there is no music. But if there is no Iliraja, there will be 1,000 musicians will come. Don't worry about it. In fact, if it is one guy, the growth will not happen. If there is a 10 people comes, the industry grows. Not only in Central. So don't think it. Person is not a management. Please remember. Probably you can take a credit. I did this, I did this. That is true. There is some reality that is also true. But aspect textbook research definition.
System.
People is not a management.
Right? There is a system.
Even people say place is not a management. Even though I said Darjeeling, Kerala, Tirupati, tomorrow in Tirunelveli and Pune, that fellow Satara Road, he constructed a Balaji temple. Still people are coming more, they are getting money. Today you can able to convert that place. Even though I said Gujarat is not a good IT, today Modi's are made it to convert that state, anything they can do. Even though that state doesn't have any natural resources as such, when you compare with other state. It is always to benchmark with others, no? We don't take the conclusion. Right? But still you proved it, no? Gujarat can be turned around, you get limited, whatever resources they may, he could able to do anything, even Gujarat has IT hubs, even Gujarat has manufacturing hubs, he proved it. So, neither people is not a management, place is not a management, even is not a management. Today you do Kumbhmela in one place, it can be done another 6 places also. Not necessarily we'll have to do it at one place. Right? Even. Also not a management. Then what is management?
Converting your thoughts into execution.
Okay. In fact, that's the best definition of management. Is a simple word. Management is
thoughts into
reality. Mr. Rosie, everyone is making an
idea.
Idea. Okay. Management is process. That's it.
Process.
Why the process? Again, there is a clause into this. The thing which I do today might be right, tomorrow it might become wrong. But the process will remain same. But the method of process will change.
Yes.
For an example, I still remember there are two tap brands here. First, I got to check a coffee clinic. Madras is a coffee, Milta, right? First, I got to check a coffee clinic. That all tap brands as the culture. So, we have two coffee clinics. Early coffee, second coffee, after the breakfast, they have one more cup. That will be cutting. Okay? How Madras will have the coffee culture, you have to tell him. Go and see how. Garma garam kitchen se aake dele pade. Garma garam aayega, tanda karke piye. Logically you can tell it no. यदि आप ठंडा करके पीने वाले में थोड़ा गर्मी कम करके दे तो सीन वो अच्छा नहीं करेगा. आप गर्मा गर्मा देने का आपका काम है, ठंडा करने का मेरा काम है, पीने का मेरा काम है. Right? See the process. And this is called coffee. Sopan. Sopan. Now what's happening here? Today we'll go ask for coffee. Coffee is not coming from kitchen. It is coming from fridge. Cold coffee. Can you call this is purpose bullshit? Coffee should be like this. That's what we tried for almost few hundred or thousand years. We don't know the history also. Coffee means as a vinegar. Tea means you know how bujus makes. Try to learn. One of the classic, you know, it has to be documented, it has to be learned, it's not easy. The way they made the tea, one of the classic, putting minimum 7 recipes. That's why today MDH Masala, his salary is 22 crores. He is higher than Adi Godrej, who makes masala tea and ice masala. And what is his salary? MDH. You know MDH? Television maker, Gundawala.
He's the richest CEO.
His salary is 22 crores. Adi Godrej will give him the money. And what is he doing? Sambar ka masala, chai ka masala, champan masala. Ye tino segment mein wo market leader. Right? So it's a great way. So that's what you know, everybody feels management means doing great things. No. Even you do simple things, you do great, you become a genius. Right? For example, management, I said word process. There is no standard template to do this word process. It differs. Today, whatever you are doing, today you said no, you are doing this course by sitting at 9 to 6 on weekend, you are paying money and sitting it. If you don't come, Radha will show you, they will say that you will go to get internal, you don't allow to sit the exam. This is method what is good for the system. Not necessarily this is the right system. Tomorrow it become video conferencing. Anyway, lectures are recorded, learn it for other time, no need to come. You will get a certificate, what's wrong? That's what is happening in person. Tomorrow no need to come to the class. That's what happened in retail, right? One time in retail, you can cut out, bar cut out, bar cut out, bar cut out, and then cut out, AC cut out. Today, there is no one goes to mobile. Still, the remaining things is happening, right? Nothing is stopped. Still, you are buying the same product. Still, you buy the chappal and shoe, chanadhan, turdhan. But the method is changing. The process always can be changed. There is no standard control. Process is all about managing. And trying to reinvent the process every time. If everything can be feasible, we will call it then as a management. Today, tea is coming from fridge, nothing wrong. As for the customers likes it, my concept is good, it's called iced tea. Ice creams is coming from oven. Ice cream fridge ne hai shishler, brownie.
Brownie sizzler.
Yeah, you have to have very carefully, otherwise your finger will be burned. Ice cream pack to garam hote hai kya? Nahi, aaj hote hai bhai. See, today that's what we call, you know, wow, this is management, the process is different. Earlier ice cream means fridge mein adega, aaj ovens mein adega. Process is alag hai, but still we call ice cream. You know? You might be wondering it, even in the corporate that's what happening itself. There is no standard control. The process is management. The thing which you do right, tomorrow might be wrong. Or today whatever you do right, tomorrow it become wrong. Or whatever today become wrong, tomorrow it become right. That also possible. You must be seeing pattern shift. That's why we call management is a process. Process is all about change. Change management. The only thing remains constant is a change. One thing remains always changing is a change. You can't do it the way what we do after this. They said we came. Okay. Right? Any question, doubts?
Yeah, I don't know what is going to be.
Yeah, you. Yeah, anything you like to ask question on this? What were you discussing? Any question, doubts you have open to discuss? Then I'll get into the other topic, what is strategy?
So because how do you relate what you said, management is about process.
Yeah.
So how do you relate this to the 2000-year-old temples?
Fabulous question. Anybody could be able to answer this question? Not necessary because you also understood, right?
So the definition, management is about process and process is change. How do we relate these to the 2000-year-old temples that were built, that we started off with?
Yeah, also it was the organized process that.
Do you think they consider the temple or anything without that all the management principles so called? Without planning, organizing, direction, coordination, motivation, control? वो टाइम में वो भी किया, आज के में भी करते हैं, वही देर फर्क है. वो टाइम में भी प्रोसेस था, आज के में प्रोसेस था. वो टाइम का प्रोसेस अच्छा है, दैट्स व्हाट आई वांट टू टेल यू. इवन टुडे इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू प्रोसेस चेंज मैनेजमेंट रिमेन सेम. डू यू थिंक इफ यू वांट टू कंसीडर टेम्पल 2000 इयर्स बिफोर दे कंस्ट्रक्टेड, डू यू थिंक दे डिड विदाउट प्लानिंग, विदाउट ऑर्गेनाइजिंग, विदाउट लीडरशिप, मोटिवेशन, कंट्रोल? आई एम आस्किंग यू, यू आर राइट टू. That's what the question should be interactive, no? You tell me, they think without management principle, without that. But unfortunately, that's what we have taught in the school.
All these words.
I can't blame you. You know why? Management means planning to control. That's what Henry Fayol, Kuhn, Mintzberg. These are the beggars, 100 years old guys. Probably they documented well, that's why became management guru in the world. Unfortunately, we never documented, we have done more work, we have done much more phenomenal work, we never said outside to the world. This is what management is all about. Probably we are not said anything, we are not documented, that's why we became growing more. Possibly. Pardon? See, whichever the definition so far, whatever you said, this is all 100 years old definition. If there is no moons, we don't know the definition of plants, organization, financial control.
Because we did not document.
We never documented anything, no? Do you think that we did 2000 years before that all this stuff? Why we never documented? Is it Vedas are documented? You know, Rig Veda, Yadu, Shama, other Vedas never documented those stuff. It has to clear through voice. They never do documentation, no? Even today, RSS meeting never documented, you know that?
Yes.
Sorry to say this, but anyway, I am telling you this. If you go to RSS meeting, important meeting, they never say this is the minutes of meeting, this is the agenda of meeting, this is what we have to discuss. Everything will be there in oral. People trust. And one generation is taken over the challenges. But if you go to any corporate, first thing they will take a notebook, they will write it, this is what is the agenda, what is this. Reality, nothing materialized. It has its own pros and cons. I don't deny it. Right? The laptop is cat agenda. So, screen is safe for them. So, for the business, 4 agenda, 5 agenda, as a record. That's why the problem comes. Whenever you do any lectures, 3 hours to the minimum lecture. Right. Okay. Clear up on management. Any question, talks?
We might have documented, but due to so many invasions, the documentation
would
have...
Possibility. I'm not, there is an argumental topic whether we do or not, but end of the day, we lost. That's the legacy.
Yes.
That is the outcome, right? Process. And other what we talk about? Outcome. That's not the mean, no? Because whenever you do efficiency, it's all about means. Effectiveness is about end. That's the difference between hard work and smart work. Probably we must be doing very great hard work. When as far as the smart work is coming, most of the principles of management, we teach him only quotes and all this efficient in Indian business schools. Because nobody thought in that world. Whatever it is. It can be reinvented, it can be discussed much more elaborately, possibility in the near future. That's why we are this type of new process, new thought process, to reinvent our own values, culture, ethics, system. That's why the purpose of this course is, right?
It is also that we already were doing all these things, but we didn't have a definition for the words and everything existed, but we
nobody
didn't
knows
define it.
That's why the people are today making an attempt. Now we are realizing it. No, this is what our culture, value, ethics, management, blah, 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 blah. Now we have to tell them outside. Boss, we know our own knowledge. We know something. Please try to listen. Because it is proven today.
The Western philosophy is all about certification. We never had that concept of being certified, certified this, certified that.
Probably if they thought that management principle in your BMS graduates or everybody must be doing graduation. If they thought these concepts, you never come into the trouble because everybody thought what is planning, control, entry fires, 14 principle, script, decals, span of control. These are the stuff. Nothing wrong about it. You learn it and without losing our core values. You have our own system. And today if you go to, I know one of my guy friend is teaching in Harvard. I can show you that like hyperlink also. And today what all Indian monks and gurus and goes everywhere and teaches Indian management, I highly appreciate it. One of my close friends, Gaurav Das Prabhu, goes to Harvard and Stanford to teach on management. He is ISKCON Vice President of Mumbai. He teaches fabulous lectures, ex-IITian guy, gold medalist. He does it. And people are appreciating it. Wow. Maybe Radha is doing from his level, his whatever effort is doing it from his own effort. He is doing it phenomenal work. People lose it. People appreciate it. Because today we feel there is a lacuna of it. Why Guru couldn't be able to do that? That's why Guruji and all, they are making an effort. Now it is coming up. पहले बात करने की ताकत नहीं है. आज चार जन बोलेगा. Now today you became 40 guys brand ambassador to escalate this group thought process. It will have multiplier effect. That's the purpose we are making. Even in business management. Now we'll come to strategy. Then we'll discuss certain different point. What is strategy? What is strategy?
Methods.
Okay. What is strategy? Because today the topic which has given to me is leadership and strategy. Yeah? So,
style.
Way of doing.
Style.
style.
A long-term achievement.
Okay, what we'll do, at this moment I won't get into the word strategy because there is a Michael Porter again. I met him personally in Singapore, one of the world-class professor. Even today he is a father of strategy board. There was a charge. In a corporate, if you go to top Fortune 500 companies, they talk about Porter is a great one. Unfortunately, he is having all these negative vibes about India. He doesn't like it. It's a reality. But whatever he has made a paper, whatever you publish, core competence, that book on strategic management, even today, highly sold across the world, translated in more than 35 languages, across the world, they use Michael Porter. Right? He is the guy who created the word strategy much more aggressive. We are not questioning it, we learn from it. Nothing wrong about it. But we will tell him also what we can be able to learn different. But today, I am not going to discuss about, maybe I will mail you one more article. What is strategy? This is for your reference. What I can suggest, any two people who are having a passion of reading an article. It's a Harvard article original. It is costing $5-6. I have a right, I will download it, I will give it to you. Don't copy, but in India we can do. In India, copy like this, copy to write.
Yes. Very true.
Yeah. In India, copy it means copy to write. That's why I stopped writing in books. You know why? బచ్చలు కితాబు లేదంటే దే వర్క్అవుట్ విత్ ద జెరాక్స్ ప్రైస్ అండ్ బైస్ ద బుక్ ఎలా జెరాక్స్ కరెక్ట్ 30 రూపాయలు దేకి బుక్ 100 రూపాయలు కట్టలేక ఎసా పోయి చలే కదా ప్లస్ ఐ స్టాప్ రైటింగ్ ఎ బుక్ నేను పబ్లిషర్స్ నెవర్ గివ్ రాయల్టీ ఐ నో ఇట్ ఇస్ మై ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ విత్ నో లిమిటెడ్ పబ్లిషర్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఐ వర్క్ నౌ డేస్ ఐ రైట్ ఓన్లీ కేసెస్ ఐ క్లోజ్లీ వర్క్ విత్ జర్నలిస్ట్ నరేష్ గోయల్ ఐ క్లోజ్లీ విత్ భారత్ ఫోర్జింగ్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ లేటర్ హౌ ద కంపెనీ లైక్ భారత్ ఫోర్జింగ్ బట్ యు షుడ్ నో దిస్ రియల్ కార్పొరేట్ టైప్ కుడ్ బి ఏ వరల్డ్ క్లాస్ కంపెనీస్ Parley, Asian Free. These are two Indian companies, Marico, Dabur, Cabin Care. Today those companies are having a guts to compete. Forget about Bharat Forging, the way he has grown. Without Bharat Forging, even today Rolls-Royce, BMW, Audi can't be able to produce the car. Or their trucks. Baba Kalyani from Pune. Baba. See, these are some real genuine workers done. Unfortunately, we never highlighted this stuff. Right? We'll discuss this some other time if time permits, but today we'll discuss this something layman's language, right? I'll come to the strategy point later. What is your understanding about? Mouse is there?
F3 better than long.
F3. Oh. How is it going
to work? F3 would work. Function F3.
It's okay. Anyway, I will say later. Yeah. What is strategy?
Better.
Apart from further insert a couple of How is it? How is it going? What is your understanding of the word strategy?
You can call it as a system or system.
System. System. Okay.
They are preparing for challenges.
Preparing for?
Challenges.
Challenges. Okay.
Long-term planning.
Long-term?
Planning.
Short-term. Very short.
Strategy short-term. Short-term. So, instead of that, what I thought today, I thought I will bring some video clips. In fact, I have that. Normally, I do this as an exercise in a workshop for the corporate. But I will do it very different way today. I thought I will change the model because I have a video clip.
Strategy is the most effective and the shortest path from your vision to execution. Or is vision to reality?
Vision to
reality.
Reality. Okay. Yeah.
It's just a plan.
Plan. So if it is a only plan, why we call strategy? Let me call plan only. No, I'll appreciate that. If it is a only plan, let call it plan. Why we call it as a strategy?
In a larger plan, where we need to.
Okay, when the plan is big and big, it's called strategy.
No. Strategy is like smaller. So the smaller part of the plan is called strategy, because strategic changes can happen when the plan cannot change. So
okay.
Sir, it's a pathway to meet anticipated challenges.
Okay, what we will do?
Sir, systematic application of thoughts.
Systematic application of thoughts. Okay. What else?
Plan of
fabulous. Plan of action, achieve the long-term goals. Fabulous. How do you define long-term here? How do you define normally long-term means? Because, no, I really don't know. If there are any bunsel in the class, you will become a billionaire in the double end of year. That's what economic times also comes. Every IT startup, every online companies are all started with bunsels. Right? And long-term, short-term, really I don't understand that. This whichever company started and mushroom and many people exited, the life of the shelf life of the company, not even product itself, is very short. Right? They so-called these companies called Unicorn Club companies. Those companies were not there 10 years before. So how do you depend on long-term, short-term in those type of organizations today? Last week we had a Mukesh Ambani also came. He also talked about today's business style, and he never mentioned it. It is this article written by Schumpeter. He took Schumpeter article and he never used the word Schumpeter, and he talked about the entire paper. That's why we became a Mumbai, right? And we became academician because we give credit to everyone. Boss, this is not my jargon. I used from this source, right? And he used entire Schumpeter of the economic theories of principle, our innovation and drives, and he made a convocation talk, right? And there also we mentioned about little bit, you know, that organization, how the future is all about, how the businesses are happening today, is the trends are changing, are we in this type of business, if you want to grow into future, what could be your strategy? Use this word after our talk. So it is really difficult, madam, today nowadays to define what is short term, long term. 20 years before we can call anything less than few months call short term plan, anything more than 3 to 5 years call long term. But today organization itself doesn't survive for 5 to 10 years. Or whichever company is giving competitors to you, I remember one time, you know, I met Ishan Goyal also, generalists are, you know. See, I am running an airline business. Example, yeah? If I get a competition from Indigo or SpiceJet, I will have fun to compete. You know why? I am a gentle guy, hypothetically. If I get a competition from Indigo is competing me, or SpiceJet is competing, or Indigo, or Indian Airlines, at least I will have fun to compete. You know why?
Someone to see.
They are from the same industry, same business they are. Now I am getting an airline company, getting a competition from Railways. Now government is running with a new project, fast trains.
Yes.
Painful.
Challenge.
Because their business model is different, mine is different. Still I have to compete. Chalo, railway ka chalo. Volvo is coming and competing. Today if you want to go to Bombay to Pune short routes, none of the guys doesn't want to go by airline. 2 ghanta pehle jaave, aur airports are outside. Bangalore jaave to 2 ghanta aate hai. Hyderabad mein aur, except Bombay, every airports are outside. It's become painful. 2 ghanta pehle jao, check in karo, and 90% people today prefer Shatabdi le lo, Bangalore to Chennai is faster, or take Volvo, absolute cheaper, right or not?
Yes.
As airline company, you have to see these examples. Getting a competition from the same industry is different, but the now competition is coming from railways, also getting competition from roadways, and also getting competition from blah blah. I am going to Pune. At least Neeta ke jaate 400 rupees hote, 500 rupees hote, 2 taka pe rukte. Now there are many clients download the app saying that I am going tomorrow 9 o'clock to Pune. I have this car. This is my driving experience. I would like to take only 200 rupees. Pick up point this location. You know how many guys were traveling? How many girls were traveling? You know that? Today if you see some of the silently grown biggest business.
Oh.
Very big business. Forget about those competition. Today Mukesh Ambani giving competition to Jetair. You know how? When? Jio aagaya. Meeting ke liye jaane ka na free pe aa raha hai. Video call karo, bindaas, quality is good. Get another one the purpose, you have to go and meet. Just imagine. railways competing airlines is a pain. Transport four-wheelers giving competition to airlines is tough. Because entirely I am running a legacy of 500 crores per aircraft with the fuel charge of the airport in the luxury. And the blah blah guys comes and give competition. So if you are in a business, how do you do? What would be your strategy? How do you face the competition? Is it, can we ignore? Or we can't ignore it? And what is the way of thinking? It is there for every business, sir. It is there in every business. Tell me which business doesn't have a competition. Any single business can be named, say this business doesn't have any competition. Entirely? What is strategy? Where is the role of strategy coming to the picture? Is it required?
The systematic approach of going from point A to point B.
Systematic approach going to point A to
point B. From X to a vision.
From X. What is?
Preparing to face the competition. Preparing to face the competition.
Preparing to face the competition is also strategy.
Sustainability.
Change. Accepting change.
Accepting?
Change.
Change. Okay, what else?
How to sustain.
Okay, I'll show a small video film. Right? I request you to observe that and then we'll discuss it. Yeah? In second half, I'll discuss this. This is one of my favorite films. I always show it in most of the conferences. Even I travel to this video film with international also. Never matches with them. That's why you become a world class person. No, honestly. In fact, the one fellow challenged the entire Japanese. Because today, why we find Japanese made automobile cars?
Quality.
Quality, technology, and one of the best manufacturing system in the world. Even today, Germans are able to compete. German talks about quality. But if we talk about the manufacturing excellence, like operational excellence, or maybe a quality, maybe the Kaizen, whatever you name it, the Japanese survived only because of, oh, fabulous. International terrorism. So IT always you never depend. But I can tell you honestly, IT strategic management in my institute in JB, all my 30 lectures, so-called 30 hours, I never depend my PPT. Only I show video clips. 80% of the problem happens just like that. Across anywhere, you never depend PPTs. I stopped teaching PPT and I written 4 books, not required. I can go over extra more talk. But still, if we depend too much IT, it will become inviting trouble. Right? Anyway, now we'll see this film with an open mind and I'm sure you'll enjoy. It's one of my favorite films. Let's try to discuss from this film, maybe another session for this, you know. Then we'll try to discuss what is strategies all about. Yeah?
Life makes an appearance in the jungle that Rajan, the Bengalese tiger and her children, have suddenly abandoned. A darker color, a coat embellished with narrower stripes, and a smaller size characterize the species. His name will be Suwa, a Thai word that means tiger. Without warning, an enemy pounces on Suwa. The second tiger, Pang, is none other than the brother of the former. The two animals continue to play, unaware that they are just under the tree that Talun the Gibbon has made the center of his kingdom.
Thank you.
Swiftly that the other person is not able to even adjust to your speed in change.
Okay, what else?
So the way...
Very good observation. What else?
Being completely persistent.
He is completely persistent. Okay, what else?
Understand your playing field.
Okay, what else do you understand from this video?
Strengths and weaknesses.
So. Okay, good. Yeah, anybody from this side? Sir. Then yeah, I'll come back to you. Yeah.
You didn't give up till you didn't try the day.
Okay, what else?
Enjoy the process.
Enjoy the
process.
Enjoy the process. What else?
Not getting intimidated by the practice.
Don't be scared.
Okay.
When the clubs came to know that we cannot compete, they just left the space away from us.
Okay. Any other observation? Yes, ma'am.
Achieving the objective of having.
Achieving the
objective of having.
Like, can I explain what is the objectives there? I mean,
displacing
the title. Okay.
He was able to fulfill that.
Even?
He was able to fulfill that.
He was?
He was the monkey.
How do you know monkey is he or she? What are the other
sir, you have told us a very short to understand all the videos. May I ask them many notices like you? But yeah, good, good, good. What else?
Like you see at the end of the video, the cops, they went away and the monkey was being sad about it. So at that we feel the monkey thing sad, you know, he was enjoying the game which was going on there. Then
okay. Yeah. Do you find anything this type of things happening in corporate now?
Yeah.
Every day.
Yeah.
Pattern of monkeys, the behavior of monkey relates with the running kawa of Maratha and
Gorilla tactics.
Gorilla attack. Shivaji never did this, sir. Sorry. I'll tell you why. At least Tiger knows monkeys are coming and attacking. But whatever Shivaji attacked, none of the Muslim Mughals couldn't able to understand when he is going to attack. Probably his attacking called Gorilla War strategy, which opponent doesn't know. For example, opponent, even Shivaji himself doesn't know his own people. That's what history says. Yeah.
I'm just wondering because he knew his own strength and he knew his opponent's weakness.
So what is your learning from this? Okay, I'll put it this way now. What is your learning? As a management, you know, you are learning from the course. What is there any learning first? then you can tell me, sir, इसमें कुछ learning नहीं होते, फिर फायदा नहीं discuss कर लेते. Then I'll change the topic. If you find out, sir, there is something good to learn, then I'll try to bring the word strategy. You know, have you find this type of things happening in today's corporate, is happening something, or have you been able to relate these things with something?
So the monkey had a plan in place.
Okay.
He knew what he is capable of. And he knew what the tigers aren't capable of. And he kept on hitting on that particular...
See, for example, entire people knows who is powerful.
Yes.
Tiger is powerful, then monkey. That is universally people knows that tiger ever. But end of the day, today's reality, if you see, monkey can do mirror stretch, even tiger can do. Assume what happened really. Assume, why this is entire step happened? Because it is in the middle of forest. Whatever monkey can do, tiger can do. Or maybe whatever tiger can do, monkey can be able to do better than that. Assume what happened really if it happened in this open field. Will it happen? It will be the same story. Monkey will be nowhere. But end of the day, who is powerful is immaterial today.
Yeah.
You might be a great guy, great powerful guy, but if you know how to use your environment with that
resources,
if you could be able to utilize your skill based on that environment, even you can become. That's what you say, size doesn't matter nowadays. 15 years before, if there is a big corporate houses, means what? Big corporate house. They have a few thousand acres, regular office, with 15,000 employees. And today we don't know, whichever companies were starting, every company is UKB. Upar wala ka bharosa. Server mein daalo, sir, paisa server mein daalo, dhanda kidhar hai? Upar. Server hai, cloud hai. And where is your business? My business, every day is corporate office which should be in a corporate location. Today, even you have office in B1T, business will run. Once upon a time, you should be in Kalimant Point or BKC. But today, location doesn't place well. And every day, is, if I have organization, I should have thousands of employees. But today, everything is outsourced. I am doing a session in IIM Indore, Business Emergence Opportunities and Challenges. And today what's happening is the concept of business itself is changing. Today everybody asks me earlier days, what's your business model? But today the question is outdated. What are the models you are available in business? You have to work it out today. There is a vast difference between business model and models available in business. Anyone friends? Anyone can able to discuss it or would like to share your views? The question which I posted. Can I repeat the question?
Okay.
Prashant, can I repeat the question? What is business model? And second is, what are the models available in business?
Yes. So business model is your core product and core service, and the business, the models of business, in what form are you planning to expand the market?
Right. Right. What else? Any other? Yes. Earlier it is put hypothetically. I want to render hotel business. Or a travel business. Now you want to start. How do you think? I mean, if you want to start, what are the things your thought process will happen?
Yes.
First you will say, yes. I will buy for at least, if I want to rent a hotel, I should have my own rooms. I should have own hotel. How many rooms I have? And I should have minimum people, blah, 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 blah. If I want to rent a taxi business, at least I should have one Omni, yes. One taxi, two drivers, and I should have a school kid, something you didn't think about. That is a conventional thought process. And today the guys who are running taxi business, doing business without tax.
Uber, the Airbnb without hotel.
The person who is having a hotel without having a hotel, so and it's proven to be worth biggest.
They have become profitable.
Well, biggest. And OYO rooms have 50,000 rooms, not even single room on his phone. And that guy doesn't know anything about hotel business. The guy who started Flipkart Snapdeal doesn't know anything about retail. They know retail in the conceptually, not like a Kishopian, hardcore retail experience. But today they have proven that they can able to do business. What parameter factor they come into the business model? If they thought the earlier question business model, today Airbnb may not be there. Ola may not be there or Uber may not be there. And today why they are there? Because they thought something different. Agree with this. That business concept we never heard. That concept was there earlier. Is there a concept of blah blah? Before? But today it is proven, right? They can also be able to do better. we are not discussing about financial perspective. Are they doing, how the business model, how they get funding? Then the topic will be deviating at this moment. Now, just I'm telling this example. Today, what's happening is business concepts are changing. Right? And today, you should be dynamic enough to understand the market offering and try to offer a product and try to connect. Strategy is nothing. Yes. I have a certain objective. I want to go somewhere. What resources I have? If I have a resource, how can I able to connect my objectives to achieve the goals? Simple. Only three steps. Where I am, where I want to go, how I will reach. The strategy is done. Again, I repeat. I have certain resource. I will decide where I want to go. How I can able to go better way is called strategy. Let me have a tea break and come back. Then we'll discuss second one. Any questions?
Where I have to go.
Will you please repeat?
How to go from where I am to where I want to is strategy.
That is strategy. See, first I should know what I am, who I am. Right? For that, first three chapters of strategy we discuss. Do SWOT analysis, BCG, TACPES, Michael Porter's. That's the way entire strategy is different. Then I know what is my core competence value chain. Then I know business level strategy. Then it's called corporate strategy. Then I will have a strategic alliance. But the major three pillars of strategy is what I am. If I have a skill, I will use the skill. If I don't have a skill, I will outsource the skill. Or I will try to build the skill. It is always I can able to do because it is the internal factor. That is my own company I can do. I can come to know when I, where I want to reach. I want to become top company, then I have to increase my resources. If I have less resource, I have to increase. I have over resource, I have to reduce. How am I going to achieve this for strategy? It's a bridging gap between the two possible. Where to whom? How? So it's called strategy.
Connection is also one of
this. Entire India is today's outsourcing. Outsourcing today's strategy. But what is, what are the things you can able to outsource? There are certain things can be outsourced. That's the top rule. What extent you can outsource that we have to be studying in an organization, what are the things can be outsourced? Outsourcing also today's people strategy. In your house also you outsource your server name, right? If you do outsource something, nothing will have impact. Still, if you know how to control it. What are the functions at your home can be outsourced, cooking can be outsourced. If you want to run a successful, satisfied, value-based, culture-based house, there are certain things not be outsourced. Still, they can outsource why, but it doesn't help you. That culture will lose. You decide, it is available, but can you able to outsource? No. You should know what is your value. You should identify your system, you should identify your structure, then you try to outsource. There is a combination how to do it. That can be discussed better. Nature of the organization, type of the organization. This is a very big topic for business. Any questions? Will I have tea break?
Yes.
Sir, tea break is in the middle. That's a great time. Tea break is in the middle. Sorry, see you after a break. See, literally, intentionally, my intention not to go into more theoretical part like MBA student. I don't teach strategies in core area and really want to teach at this moment. First lecture, I'll give the, what you say, the glory of the basic understanding of strategy. I'm making an attempt. It's only 3 hours, right? We can't able to teach MBA stuff in 3 hours. Take some time to digest also. Maybe we'll ask one more slide discussion on strategy. The video clip which you have seen, Monkey and Tiger, it's all about classic strategy. End of the day, that's why I asked you the question, are we find today's corporate is it happening? Definitely we'll find Patanjali now competing HLL and PhD.
Okay.
Right? It is not happening today. History always repeats. Even it happened in HLL, PhD earlier days, Nirma competed. Kasanbhai Patel, cycling is a government employee, cycling, washing powder in a cycle. He proved it. He can able to compete India's biggest brand without advertisement, without branding. 4 rupees, 5 rupees kilo. HLL lost the market share.
Even Asian Paints and Burger and ICI.
That is one of the classic examples. In fact, I closely work with Asian Paints. I don't know what's so profile. In fact, I never took anybody's profile here. Normally I do. Because
I heard that Radha also said she is one of the best students we got. They came on their own interest with the age also, he told, and the profile. Happy to see you, but what's your profile? Because many people doesn't know about Asian Paints and Dollar unless if you are not either a dealer or employees. Many Indian companies doesn't know about many things. We know only HL and PHU. We don't know what is Marico. Gandhi Bhai.
Yes, tell me.
You know why it's called Marico?
No.
There is a beauty of the company.
Doctor's
Mari company.
Marivala.
That is Ash Marivala. It's not a daughter name. In India, we keep surname our name. Batli wala, lakda wala, moja wala, daru wala, biscuit wala, bagda wala, nagda wala. Nothing wrong. That our culture, we should be proud of it.
Yes.
I can tell you challenge, whenever I go to the class, by seeing the face, I can tell you which state you are coming from, what language you are.
Oh.
Nothing. Yeah, it's easy to understand. No? You ask the name, we'll come to know the names. If Malayali means, they keep their house name. You don't need to tell. When Radha assistant, that lady came, I said, I don't want lunch in Tamil. She says, how do you know that? I face me malum kar desne ke likhne ke jaru. When I entered, I found these two southern names. I never met him, I told him on his own. I teach every semester close to 2,000 students across IIMs to any premium biscuit to low profile school. Our name, Andhraites, it's a uniqueness. We should not leave our culture and religion, because even if we fancy name, we can understand our religion culture. Even if you don't anything, if you open your mouth with your English communication, you will understand he's from Bihar or UP or Kerala or Malayalam. For example, Ash Marivala, I used to tell him that I am, sir, people get shocked. You know why it's called Ash Marivala? Marico. It's a good company, India's only company that put IIMs, very big company. Today's become billion company turnover, 5,000 crore plus, coconut oil. Parachute became a brand. I said, Marico became Marico. Ash Marivala is name. Why Marivala? In Mari means in Gujarati pepper.
Pepper.
Yeah,
black pepper.
Curry Mari. They call black pepper. And he used to trade business of pepper.
Swadhi.
90% pepper even today produced in Kerala and Karnataka coastal area. Not coastal area, the hill stations. That mountain station, no? And Kerala produces largest number of pepper even today. Ash Marivala used to do trading pepper. And they realized that coconut oil from Kerala even today is one of the highest manufacturing capacity put up a plant in Kerala. Biggest is parachute. That's why even people can't believe Ash Marivala could able to buy a product from HLL. Nihar. Ash Marivala competed HLL. Even HLL can't able to survive. He sold the coconut oil business to Marivala. And Ariola took this company and killed it. That is different. That's why he became market leader. Right? Marico became Marico. Today if you see many companies, Asian Paints, Marico, Parley, Bharat Forging, there are world-class Indian companies, huh? You should keep eyes on it, because these companies, ITC, Cavit Care, Micromax, Jain Irrigation, L&T, you keep on talking about, these are all the great companies which has a great leaders. Why is it Asian Paints and what is your experience with Asian? Otherwise you may not be told to you. What's your preference?
Rajesh Patik. I am a B.Tech in Petrochemical Engineering. I was doing research at IIT Bombay. And then I did my MBA from NITI.
NITI? Which year? I teach in NITI also? 96.
What I did 96.
Oh, 96 is too. I just started teaching after 2007.
And then I was competitor to Asian Paint because I was with ICI Paint.
ICI.
So management case study, Asian Paints, the way they have grown the distribution. Distribution was their strategy to
Not only distribution, this company is highly innovative. Whatever they do around course. I still remember the Asian Paints, their name is called Bharat Paints in 1950s and 60s. They used to keep a paint box, Dakkan Kapoor Ekrupa Rakhtatha. And every painter come in and say, sir, Asian Paints are अच्छा है क्यों उसका एक रुपए मिलते हैं ना डंकन बोलने के लिए एक रुपए ही डॉलर पैक करके दे दो दैट्स व्हाई द कंपनी स्टार्टेड दे आर फ्रॉम सिडनी
इफेक्ट व्हेन दे
प्रमोटर्स आर फ्रॉम सिडनी कॉलेज
सो व्हेन एशियन पेंट्स लॉन्च नन ऑफ द रिटेलर्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स इन द सिटीज वर रेडी टू गिव देम स्पेस सो दे वेंट टू रूरल मार्केट्स एंड दे क्रिएटेड डिमांड देयर एंड दोस रिटेलर्स हु कम टू द सिटी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर एंड आस्क फॉर एशियन पेंट्स सो दैट्स हाउ दे वेंट
In fact, Asian Paints created a story. They have 50 ml paints also. people used to wonder what they do. Because they went to the Tamil Nadu, most of the horns used to paint with during the Pongal time with the red and green. They used to come sample paint, they made it a big business. One of a classic company. Probably if I tell you, you get shock of your life. This company went to Egypt. Just I'm giving interaction, no? Because people have to understand that how Indian companies, because never coming to that, many people doesn't know. Because we always talk about, you know, Walmart, Tesco, Carrefour, McDonald's, bloody Yedadri, those makers are learning from India. They have to learn Yedadri, they have to come to India and learn. India is going to the future market, definitely China. Nobody can able to compete. Right? Asian Paints went to Egypt. Asian Paints do miracle with 30 rupees. They call thinner. You buy a distemper, put 30 rupees. That thinner, two drops, the color will change. Go and check it out. And the Asian Paints became distemper, one of the largest selling products. Even today, you'll get for 5 kilo for 300 rupees or 10 kilo for 500 rupees. Even if you spend 600 rupees, the room will be changed. I'm telling you honestly. The room can be changed.
1 kg pack would serve. That was their cost.
28 rupees. That time. This company comes with shade card. Probably you know, world largest shade card is Asian Paints. They painted local railway, 12 car, all the paints. They become a shade card world longest. Record also there. So this guy went to Egypt for paint business. They are not in commercial paint, they are in retail paints, decorative paints. There are two segments. Right, sir?
Yes, decorative.
Decorative is for work purpose. Commercial paints are different. Asian Paints very good in decorative paints. So if you go to Egypt and all, they don't do plaster only. Pathar rakhega, cement rakhega. Actually, this is called plaster. They never do plaster. In Egypt, all the houses remain cement with bricks. What Asian Paints can do? And every color, it's a necessary, you know, they use only white color, no other color. Culturally, there is a range. But if the Asian Paints did a strategy to break the market, what they did, you know, within white color, they came with 12 different colors. Milk white, light white, yellow white, greenish white, within white. So every customer started buying using it. Everybody said, my house is not white, huh? Mine is yellow white, milk white. Then they started other colors. Today, Egypt is transport. Everybody today do plastering. See, the strategy is all about creating opportunity. This is one of the fabulous subject I can keep on discussing. Right? And strategy is one of the finest tools apparently. For example, I ask this question most of the time whenever I go for conferences or guest lectures. You know Alexander? Alexander is the great. What should you? Yeah. It's very interesting, no? What was my question? You know Alexander? Immediately Nega said, not really Nega, everybody said, I know Alexander, Alexander is the great. No, no, one second. You tell me, I asked for me, you know Alexander. Everybody said, I know Alexander is the great. Every third beggar in that Catholic community is Alexander. Or Disosa. Right or wrong? If you are a clever student, you should have said which Alexander you are asking. Are you asking about PC Alexander? He is also governor of Maharashtra, governor. You never asked. And Alexander means great. Am I right?
Yes.
Nobody in this class also knowing which year he born, what he has done, why he is called great also. We know with the 2-3 sentences. I tell you which are the 3 sentences, everybody invariably, everybody tells them. Why Alexander is called great? They have access and because? Yeah, he conquered. He is the only person conquered, definitely never conquered. You know, every people in the Asian population has the one DNA of Genghis Khan. Upcoming DNA checker again, out of entire class, mein Che Chan ka, Genghis Khan ka DNA match ho gaya. No!
Iska DNA
is
that? You don't
know?
Iska?
Iska.
You don't know that. Go to Google, I always tell, whatever I tell you can go to Google and search it out. He is a Mongolian warrior. He conquered entire that China and India and all, and he is one of the...
He's very cruel.
Oh, very cruel. The way he fights, no. But you will never call him as a great Genghis Khan. Napoleon is much more stronger. But we don't call him Napoleon is the great. Napoleon, Daru Kabhi Lok Bolte Acha hai, but King Khan hai Bolte. But we don't need, you don't know, Alexander is the great great. Now this is Genghis Khan is great. Go to Google and type the great Genghis Khan, you don't get anything. Great Alexander Bhutto Lok Mahanamartha. Yeah, packaging is another part, right? I'll tell you why it is, there is a reason for it. In fact, I used to be interested, I'm really wondering, already 12:30, can we start the lecture? Because if we start direct for 3 hours, and Alexander is the great leadership. There are many history, he says, many warriors. That history says everybody is the great, Shivaji is the great, both of them. Probably Maharashtra, within India, we can say South Maharaj is Maharaj. But if you go to outside India and say great Maharaj, people doesn't know. The entire world knows. Not only you, across the world knows, great means only Alexander, Alexander is great. You seen the movie?
Alexander.
300 Spartan?
Yes.
Have you seen the movie? There is a one more movie called Troy?
Yes.
What is the character name?
Helen.
You remember what is the character name?
Achilles.
You know that Alexander is born with silver spoon. His father is a king. He is never born with any soldier. Whereas Achilles, born as a soldier, became a great leader. He is a great warrior, better than Alexander. That's why Alexander in history, you can see, he went to Achilles' tomb and offered his prayer. That's why also you will know this part is called Achilles' heel. Why it is called Achilles' heel? They dumped the holy water, that part is not touched by the holy. That's why he was attacked there and killed. You are not questioning right or wrong. Achilles is better warrior than Alexander. Even Alexander accepted it. But we can call great Achilles. Why we call Alexander is the great? I proved you, he is not a great warrior. He is not the only great warrior. I mean, there are many great warriors. You know that Indian kings during that time, Raja Cholan and the South Indian kings went to enter Australia, Africa, everywhere. One time a boat will be there, how many Indian boats are going to go? Navy is the word, it's a Sanskrit word called Navy. Indian ships always used to stand across the world. And if you know Rajaraja Cholan, the guy who constructed the temple, they call Gadarapada, the history says, this guy went to across different part of the country and conquered and came back. But we don't call him as the great. We only call Alexander as the great. Why? I'm not teaching history, I don't know. I'm teaching you strategic leadership. Why Alexander is great?
He was one of the most leaders to create the larger influence and fear element among the people. So things
creating a fear element. No. Actual fear element created by Genghis Khan. You know that before the war starts, Genghis Khan used to chop the body into 20-30 pieces. कोई लेकर डरता था इंडियन लोग लेकर बाहर में तारा क्या करते हैं वैसा बात है कि they make equals other equal panic with others highly cruel king in the world. Alexander is not that kind of, sorry, if he has done, people never call him as a great. Why Alexander call him as a great?
It probably was a overall package including all the different aspects.
Sir, packaging branding छोड़ दीजिए, ये सब जा कर अभी चालू हो. Any other point? I mean, I appreciate that. But, yeah.
Meaning not only a warrior, he was a good leader, a people's man, he had a noble, probably a noble vision, etc.
What else? Which why Alexander is a great?
Maybe he was a great strategist.
Answer is right, but still any other? Why he calls great strategist?
Yeah. Alexander traveled east and basically there was another thing that none of the things from that.
Pardon?
He traveled east.
So he traveled east, that's why he's became a great
son. So the story goes something like that. The story goes something like that.
So traveling east, not necessarily he should become a great son. Must be some other reason.
Probably before he attacked the nation, he knew exactly what's happening in the nation and what he needs to do about it. And okay. How many should go ahead with this?
He was very good
but
at
I don't
planning.
Know.
He was very good at planning.
But I don't know. Even we came to India and fought against Biharis. He couldn't have to win. Yes. History says he literally lost the war.
Because
but still he said that finally he won it because he never expected the Indian elephants. Never expected that Alexander horse never experienced with elephants. And Horus. You read the book, every history will retain.
Horus, he lost.
Horus lost. That's what history says. But actually, they said that
monsoons again.
That's what. There is a different history altogether. But end of the day, he couldn't able to come
inside.
Cross
inside.
Bihar.
Yeah.
So Bihar is much more stronger. Even Alexander has stopped it. He couldn't able to cross.
That was because of the strategy followed by Chanakya.
Okay. Any other? Why Alexander ruler?
What is the war strategy which he used? Basically, see again this one Parvateshwar, basically porous war which we talk of. That is also one where he fought in monsoons across the river, and the way he fought it, you know, the people were sent on a dead island during night, and then so the strategies which he used to use in war.
Any other?
Was it a unique strategy that he was using?
There is no unique strategy. That's the moral of the story. If you come to know my another 5-6 lessons, you will come to know. There is no standard tempo. This is called strategy. It differs area to area, location to location. If you use same strategy everywhere, you bound to fail. That's no standard. Same strategy can't be used across the time, across the time. No.
Flexibility.
Okay. Why Alexander is the great? Because your topic is leadership. Huh? That's why I have to take some 2-3 characters. And I'll tell him still why we don't call him as Alexander the Great, because he must be born before Christ. 300 years, or you know, that very old guy, you know, history almost few thousand years later, still we remember Alexander the Great. Why we call him Alexander the Great? There are multiple reasons. One of the reasons could be, he never lost single battle in his history. But you can ask him, sir, how many years he stayed? He was actually in the battle for just 12 to 15 years, not more than that. He came to his father at the age of 18. I think he died early 30s. I don't know what age he died, 34 or 35, I don't know. He was there only actively for 15, 18 years. But the part he acquired, in fact, he is the one person who had a great vision. He said there is only one word, it is called Alexandria. He wanted to bring entire world under his one forum. He had a vision, see that vision that time. Normally war happens for historically, people say, why war happens? Only for 3 reasons. You know 3 reasons why? 90% war happens because of females.
Yeah.
No, true. You see the Troy. Helen, she said, no? Helen. 90% war happens, if you see the real history, war happens because of female. Second, war happens because of?
Language.
Ego. Attitude. In the form of land, property, assets. That's it. There is no chair, what happens, anything other is.
Possessing.
What are you saying? Ego, attitude, that's it. Hey, what are you naming, madam? But if you see reality, most of the last wars come because of people. He is happy with the girl, he wants to marry that girl, then the girl wants to. I say what I want. Good history, who do you come to? But Alexander, no, Rama and Jambu, Rai and Jambu, they
were. Basically, the men are stupid, that's it.
Hey, men are stupid, huh? Remember, females are intelligent. Let it be. No arguments on it. Because
there'll be a war.
This is a
strategy.
No school of thoughts, let it be, because you know. Alexander also says, look, strategy, we should war with the equal power. If you fought arguing with the stupid, you never win the war. So better not to argue anywhere. This strategy. I don't say that. Better not to argue. Simple. If you want to do argue, do where there is a required. This Alexander did a strategy. He fought many wars across the different period. And he had only one mission called Alexandria. Right? And whatever they said, he fought for. Definitely want to bring entire world for one reason. The history says, whomever you fought, normally you see the Troy, 300 Spartan, you come to know. Once they win the battle, they kill the kids, they take the girls as a slavery or whatever it is, they literally screw the happiness of the girls and they burn the city. That's a normal culture post-war. Normal. Alexander never did in his life. There is history says after the war you give back to the kingdom to this place, you run it. But remember, I am the great warrior. If you lost, obviously he is the great warrior, right? He never lost in his battle. But the beauty, I like to go back to the earlier slide, video clip, my key and time. He fought with many people, different cultures, different times. I like to tell you only 2-3 thoughts which happened in the history. I am not going to discuss the entire, you can go through Google and check it out, whatever I said right or wrong. Persian and Romanians. Persian, one of the biggest warriors during that time. Persian kings are very famous during that time. They are much more stronger than Alexander. Romania is only one place where he comes from. But he proved that he made it into Greek culture, culturally deficient, Alexander. If you see during that time historical fact, how Alexander created his Macedonia to India. During that time, please remember, America is not invented, sir. America and all invented recent years. Many people doesn't know there is a country called US. Probably they might be there, Aryan system or Aryan culture is with, I don't know that. But history says, this is what it's all about. Even Africa is not invented by gold. Normally even Africa also is not explored. Entire world, China, India, always used to see European countries. But within short span of 15-18 years, Alexander could able to bring entire movement. If you see, this is what is one of the biggest in the time during that time, without communication, without Facebook and WhatsApp. Please remember. It's not easy to travel 100 kilometers also. Read history, one of the finest subject to know about. Why Muslim countries always become successful, why they are good business friends? Any reason? Guru also mentioned in lectures. Why Mughals, Muslim countries, Arab ways, always best in business?
They are always traders. Traditionally they
were. Why they became traders? What of how they became great traders?
Because it was a desert and they were connecting Europe and India. They were in between.
Strategically
India.
Located. Then?
And in the desert you cannot grow anything, so you can only trade.
They had a camel. Early days, what animals we have, that makes you a sir. And this guys could able to travel across the world with the help of camel. That's why they became a traveler, one of the finest assets to them. See the history, very interesting, right? And if you see this, the movement is order of being complete city and states, and believe me, he conquered many of the places. And Alexander, if you talk about, before getting to that, what is the great thing about Alexander if you come across? See that. World best philosophers. Today if we talk about Chanakya, yeah, I'm telling you reality. Are you talking about Chandragupta?
No.
Chanakya is much more famous because Chanakya is a school strategist. He is not a great warrior. Warrior is Chandragupta. Please remember, Major Thumb Rule. That's why today also in today's, there is one Economic Times covered article. India's corporate houses are outsourcing the brains. And they took 7 people interview. Abim Koragiwala, Tiger, that Jetpack CEO. And they took 5-6 CEOs and they took an interview. Even companies like billionaires, startups, they outsource sometimes brains for the strategic decisions. Because they can't able to take the decision. In that article, my name also appeared. One of my client, Larson Boyle's optical store, they took Vivek Mendoza interview on that. They said, we are 9 family members, it's a family run business. When we want to get into some new product development or idea, strategic development, I can't able to convince my own family member. If somebody external guy said comes in, we listen. If I tell my own brother and sister, there's an Arabica cat. Even though they are capable, they are real running a business. They outsource brains. Please understand, Alexander is a great warrior, no doubt about it. But he has a fabulous mentor. The first thumb rule, if you talk about it, strategy, right? Strategists are different. Chanakya is a great strategist, not necessarily to be a warrior. Right? And Alexander became a great because of Aristotle. Aristotle, you know who is the guy, right? And the beauty about Alexander, he listened to everybody. If he has not listened, probably may not become a great. The purpose is what I am saying, you should have open-minded to listen to everybody. Chandragupta listened to Chanakya. If he has not listened, he may not. right? So Aristotle not only taught arts, science, culture and policy, he taught everything to Alexander. Whenever he fought in the war, Alexander, that EQ, IQ, UQ, during that time only, he has more application mind in the war rather than physical mind. Genghis Khan has more physical. Dimagne chetta Bharata Maragoli, that's it. Never thought of opening it. But Alexander not only fought for it, he also knew the culture. He also knew what the ethics. He followed it in the war. I'll explain to you later the part, just a beauty. And Aristotle also did that. He never said, you learn only from me. Aristotle brought other experts also to come and teach Alexander. Right? And also we talk about, Aristotle also helped him to produce past analysis. Very important. Today we talk about SAS, data analysis,
regression
method. Whatever you use, Aristotle taught it to Alexander. How to learn from the past. How to take decision for the future. Right? These are the basic points which I want to explain one by one. Right? And we talked about couple of wars. Alexander did many wars with many people. First, we would like to discuss one of the war, what he has done with Persians. Yeah? I may not go more in depth. Okay. Right? If you see, go to the Google if you want, write down the names. Yeah? War of Issus. War of Babamala. These are all historical war. I request you to kindly go to the Google and read what made them this wars are called historical.
War of Issus.
I will show it in PPT, it's coming. Right? War of Issus. Normally war happens what?
For land. Power.
Persians. Romanians. This guy will hit from this side, this guy will hit from this, there will be a battleground. Maybe this guy will have 20,000 warriors. This guy will also 20,000 warriors. This is the way war happens. There are war rules, ethics, no?
Yeah.
Indians are highly ethical about wars. In fact, there is the only country in the world historically used to find wars happening separate, agriculture happened separate, and the community which is meant for warriors, Kshatriyas, if we talk about, they never business with businessman community, they never touch. In India, warriors, they never touch females and kids. Highly ethical. Highly ethical in India, that's why we lost, because we follow ethics or not. Most of the Mughals never followed that. That's why we lost with all the battles. If we followed ethics, those guys, today we will be always India is only the top of the world. Anyway, war started this. 18 years old, Alexander took it, that war from his father Philip. And Persians, equally well, highly strong commercials, you can see highly strong army in the world. When war happened, I'm giving it, go to whom you will come to know, they deputed equal power. I'm a legend. Some chokra ke mujhe fight kar rahe, we legend lo, kya karne wale? They started the war. I'm telling you what happened in the war. Alexander made 20,000 people, broke into two. 20,000, 10,000. I'll explain to you understand what happened. Persians also came. Alexander told his guys, this 10-10, don't fight. Just to go silent. And this 20 he made it into 3 divisions. Can you understand what I'm saying? He said, try to attack this way. And these guys go back and start from back, hitting from the back, also hit from the front. What happened? War completed in 2 hours. Historical war. Persian king called Darius. 3. He led from the war. In the history of war, they never heard. Unheard in the history. You know how? Attacking from the back also, front also. Without attacking, these guys wanted to side. And Alexander hardly lost out of 20,000 people. Might be he lost 1,000, 2,000 people killed. Whereas Persian killed more than 60%. War won. And it is completely standing. Can you understand what I said? It's never happened in the history of war, as any war person there. And he used more brain than physical war. In before Christ, 333, the year. Now Persian says Darius was left from the battlefield. After a year, again the war started. It's called Battle of Issus, I-S-S-U-S. This time, you know what Persians done? Alexander has 40,000 people with him, not even 20, it's 40. In Issus also, they have 40,000 soldiers. This time, Persians said we'll have a double, 1:2 ratio. Actually, history says 1:3. He had 40,000, Persians has 1 lakh. And that time, just imagine there's no AK-47 and all, you'll have to kill one by one. Please remember. This time what happened? They increased the battle size, army battalion size to twice. And they selected the place called Issus. Go to Google, you'll come to know the Google map. Right? Can you even understand this picture? Can you even understand what it is? Google map?
Oh, this.
This is a real location, strategic location where the war happened. You will find it in Google. You know why they selected this time Persians? Oh, they are also not stupid guys. They know what is war is all. This time they selected the location called Gulf of Issus. There is a full of water this side. One side full of water. Assume this is a battlefield. This entire right hand side is full of water. And this right hand side, left hand side is full of mountain. Why they selected this location? Because they realized that this Alexander क्या करते हैं? झगड़ा नहीं करते हैं, ये साइड में आदमी लोग भेजते हैं। अभी क्या करते हैं? How they did the selection this time? They made it 1 lakh people, 1:2 ratio, whereas Alexander is only at 40,000, and the way they selected the location, strategic location. You know why? आप पानी भी नहीं तुम सकते। You can enter into the water, another side full of mountain. Now, this is what the location is. How this kept the target you see to them. Can you imagine? Red is Persians, this is Macedonians, that is Alexander. Either Pandya, either Pada. Why they selected that? Because Persian thought Alexander will go from the side and start hitting from the both direction. Now Alexander options are
closed.
Stop. And if I kill one people, there are two people there to kill me. Physically, yeah? No AK-47 at all. Just imagine. There is no missile or anything. Olden days, war happened physically. Now if you are Alexander, what strategy must be used? We are talking about strategic leadership. Why Alexander became a great leader in the world? That's a comment. Yeah. If you are Alexander, what you must be under? Earlier on they experienced it. They thought Alexander is the person who used the same strategy. The moral of the story, same strategy may not be used every time. The strategy which is work out today may not be work out for tomorrow. That is a computer strategy. Yeah.
Use ships and go from behind. Using ships from the Gulf of Issus.
You are in Gulf. Ship means your core business is not riding a ship. No, you are not battling in the water. It's not a navy. It is on the battle on the ground. आप ship करने के जाएं तो आपका purpose क्या है? Ship में जाने का झगड़ा करने का.
तो पीछे से जाएं.
आप पीछे से जाने क्या फायदा है? Ship का पद आपका बस किधर है? You are going to somebody's turf. No, you have to use the local resources for fighting. You can use the resources something which is not imaginable. You must be seen the movie Try. That's why you are hoping that, you know, the climax, the guy comes inside that.
So probably the way they did it, Troy, like, you know, that fireballs, roll it from the mountains and destroy maximum people.
Okay, any other idea? What he must be done, Alexander, to fight that? Here you can see that.
He must have used special weapons to attack them.
Okay. Now we'll see one small video clip. I don't know whether how many people can able to see that, right? Battle of Issus, right? You can go to Google and cross check it, whatever I'm telling right or wrong. Because very interesting, please read it. For your own passion.
Yes, sir, we don't doubt you.
No, it's very interesting to read because this is what the beauty is all about. Size doesn't matter. Today, iPod shuffle killed the big companies. The size of the shuffle, I'll discuss later the corporate side. Just examples. This is one of the video stream of Alexander. This character depicted Alexander.
When I called the war gods,
can you increase the volume?
Proved to me the war man. But I have choice.
Dallas.
Prayer and prostrate arms of Buddha Mother. Grant me through righteousness the increase in the kingdom and the fruit of the story. Come to my support and my call.
Stop this for a minute.
Yeah. Oh, you started the DLC?
Yeah.
Okay. Our pull is better now.
And now we can
go. Oh God of fear, to you and against failure, I make sacrifice. I now call upon all the gods to prove to me and to all men that I am truly the son of heaven. By giving me this day victory. This aid I beg in prayer with outstretched arms of Buddha Mazda. Grant me through righteousness the increase of my kingdom never to be destroyed. Come to my support at my call.
You generals, companions, officers, this message would make you choose
how the language is served. One fellow is praying a God given power. This day, motivating others to become a God. That is the difference. See that.
This day, Greece will be revenged, all Asia will be ours, its riches in our hands, and all our labors ended. This then is the plan of battle. We are outnumbered in everything save courage and discipline. But the Macedonian army is such that even if I, Alexander, were to fall in battle, only one man would be lost.
I want to see your
Persian
will ask the question
such
this.
Yeah? That if the head is cut off, the rest of the body dies with it. Therefore, Macedonians, hold and wait. Hold and wait. Then when we charge, have but one thought. Kill Darius. Kill Darius.
One object.
Kill Darius.
You see him, he's chanting, the great king has played, he is run away!
Then we may bury him before he put us to death.
Your father is alive. I bear no hatred toward you or your family, Queen. He's braver than his father. What's your name?
Opus.
And yours?
Amiti.
Now I'd like to share my views on these 7 minutes we saw the video. What is your understanding from this one? Is there any major observation what you observed in the world? I have told you the earlier case, how the first battle happened, how we started from the attacking. Whereas this time in the war of the Issus, they selected the strategic location where Alexander can be able to attack from this side. Right? Now the options were stopped because of one side water, one side mountain. Now in this war, what happened? Have you observed any major observation in this slide?
So he didn't attack, he waited for the attack to happen. And then...
So just imagine they're waiting for the attack. What do you understand from this? What is the major impact?
You understand their strategy.
No. There are two things now. You don't have option to attack. In fact, if you see the Darius used to get confused. You don't know what this guy is Alexander is doing. He must be wondering, right? See, for example, you play cricket, I'll give layman example, you understand better. How many people play cricket? Okay, when you are getting a slack over, right? You are expecting to hit a six with aggressiveness or first 2 over. If the dead ball comes, what is your reaction?
Frustration.
No, you can't expect that if the dead ball comes, you expect that, you know, for example, that the fastest bowler, Rawalpindi Express is coming and is throwing at the 30 km speed. Can you imagine what will happen? You can't expect, because for example, normally we used to say we react based on the actions. It's a normal human tendency, right? If I slap you, by default, your body language goes this. You know, your brain will calculate like this, I'm slapping, so you keep like this. That is our body language. Here the war is happening, that also 1:2, they already lost the war, they increased the battalion size to 1:2. I'll show you the numbers now. Then you will understand what I said. Then you can imagine how the story could have been. See, this is the war it's standing. This is called Alexander. 1 second, exactly off the thing. He kept the battle like this, whereas Persians kept like this. Now, what will be the strategy he has done? This time also, he want to attack from the front, but he created a planned confusion. Tactics. Tactics is different from strategy. What he has done here, Alexander? What is their purpose? They want attack from the both the sides. If you see that war exactly, when they started coming, see, if the both the people come aggressively, the war will happen. Assume you are coming with Persian army. You are coming to aggressively to fight. There is 100 meters between this. This guy comes with 50 km speed, this guy has to come 50 km. So they meet at a common point at the same speed and vigor. Whereas Alexander said, let them come, why are you worried? This guy is expecting that this guy also will come aggressive. But only, baki
दाने का बदला उसका मारल नो तक जाएगा मतलब देर उनका टायर दैट दे लिटरली फील नो दैट मॉरल इज डाउन अरे वो लोग क्या करते हैं झगड़ा करने के लिए वो लोग ऐसे करना है बाय द टाइम व्हेन दे ट्रैवल फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर दे ऑलरेडी लॉस्ट देयर मेंटल पावर व्हाट दिस गाइस हैव डन व्हेन दे आर कमिंग विद द ओल्ड हॉर्स राइट विद द इफ यू सी दैट हॉर्स ओल इट्स अ प्लान they practiced it's not just like that they said let them come first let them allo jhagda karne ke liye aaya kar de to main jhagda nahi karta see that is a war normally war means we used to fight but this guy said no need to fight let them go so they created a space for them they got now horse ulta wapas karna hai to mushkil hai time is important then they said now you can attack from the back so they thought they'll create a chariot with the horses become a strength they made it into business and see this very interesting I will notice it carefully in the video blink there is a confusion yaar mai kya kar raha hai alexander always used to stand from the front you see that guy persians pura karte piche kar deta and whereas alexander used to stand front in the warrior it makes difference in the warrior leaders always leads from front and this guy also said I'm not going to attack If you are in this position, what you must be done? If you are Alexander, what would be your strategy? Assume you are Alexander, war is done. 1:2 ratio. एक आदमी मरा तो आपका दो जन मरने वाले हैं. That means the possibility will be less. 18 years old chokra hai. If you are Alexander, what you have been done? In this war situation. Alexander take every war as a strategy please remember he never thought it's only a physical it's also a mental game you can go to google you will come to more video games now see the beauty Alexander thought this guy has to fight with this guy who stand in the brain they are the liabilities not asset am I right or wrong
yes
What are the purpose they stand? Maybe numbers are more. In a war, how they communicate, how the people react, it's very tough to communicate on the war style. Over time, loudspeaker नहीं है, बड़ा भी है, messaging groups नहीं है, only they have some sort of communication. In the war, what happens? Whoever stands in the back, have to make isolated. How do you do it?
If you But it's not always that people at the back are liabilities. Like in war, Indian war.
They might be asset, but Alexander made them the liability. That's why I'm telling you.
How?
That's why I'm asking how. Any idea? How he made it? 1:2 ratio. 40,000 people, 1 lakh people. If this guy goes and hit directly in the same caliber, whatever you name, the casualty will be more. For example, if I kill you, I'm killing one. By that time, there are two people or more. They can kill me more. In fact, Alexander must be lost the war. Still, he won the battle. I'm giving you output also. He won the battle.
He created confusion in their mind. They were so puzzled up. Ki what is his
How reaction? How did he create confusion? This is a war.
Because he was expecting a response.
In fact,
those people were expecting
What happened is, the Allies could not run away because his army was standing behind. And they could not...
Any other reason?
He demoralized them.
See, for example, now you are all sitting. You are like a Persian. I am a Romanian. You are the king. Darius. I want to attack you. Now if I come one-to-one attack, I will also keep 40 people here, attack you. To reach you very difficult because there are 30 people behind you, behind also, front also. Possibility is very difficult. If I want to reach you first, what should I do?
You just cut through and come in between, right?
I can't cut through,
no.
Yes. That is unheard in the history of war. You know what Alexander did? I want to reach you, no? He created every game as a strategy. He used to play, think every time. You know what has done to reach to him? To reach to him, how can I reach faster? He created, started attacking from the arrow. Alexander always leads from front as a leader. What I will do, I will go with the speed, with the aggressiveness. I will go and hit 100 people on the same direction. Once if we kill, there will be vacuum is created. Sablog mar gaye na? वो वार में जस्ट इमेजिन 1 लाख लोग उधर आप लोग रहते हैं ना आपके क्या इधर आने के सोचने का पहले आई किल्ड एवरीवन यू आर क्लोजर टू मी आई कैन किल यू फास्टर I'll show the slide, you'll understand. Again, I'll repeat.
They entered from the side.
Now, see the diagram, you'll understand. Whoever people are here, they are all asset. But who give the comments? How do they come to know how it is happening? It by happening a fraction of time, he started attacking from the side, which is unknown in the history. But he never did this in the earlier one. Once if we reach, create a vacuum here, if we kill the king, what is done? But here also Darius left. Right? There is a one war happened. Go to Google and search. Actually, that output you see, Alexander in the, all the wars, he had only 40,000 as the army says. Persians has more than 1 lakh. First war, 1:1 ratio. This Gaut, war of Issus, 1:2 ratio. In this war also, Darius left. The third war happened after 3 years, very planned. That war is called, even today it is called historical war. You know why historical war? That war name called War of Gaugamala. Gaugamala. It's a real place. You know why? That earlier war is 1:1 ratio with Persian. Second is almost 1:2.5 or 2. You can see the numbers. 41 lakh. You know what is the Gaugamala war? You know what is the Gaugamala war? The ratio? Alexander never increased, only 40,000 people with him. All the wars. In Gaugamala, says that I have only 40,000. Whereas Persians included into 6 lakhs. 40,000 people has to fight with 6 lakhs. And historically, if you go to Google Map, even today, Persians' army stood for 5 kilometers. Now, you know why 5 kilometers? Because Alexander side mein ka attack karte na. Isme kiya na. Idhar aake kiya na. अभी 5 किलोमीटर मतलब वो किधर तक जाएगा, इधर से आप बैटर तक जाएगा क्या? वार में 1:8 रेशियो, 1:12 इट इज अनऑफिशियल हिस्ट्री नंबर्स, वी आर नॉट गेटिंग रियल नंबर्स. एंड अलेक्जेंडर एवरीबडी टीम गॉट मोटिवेटेड, डीमोटिवेटेड. आई सेड वी कांट किल 1:6 or 12, वॉट एवर यू डू, 1:2 इम्पॉसिबल, 1:12. You can't imagine one fellow killing 8 people, it's impossible. Even Alexander, one day dream, before the war he got a dream. And he told all the people in the battle, I said, today I got a dream, we won the battle tomorrow. And he speaks with the moral words, how he is boosting it, he created innovation, he created new war weapons. Believe me, sometime Persian also got doubt. They said, boss, instead of fighting it, whatever you want, we'll go compromise. We don't want war, let you go compromise, why to you casualty? Alexander said, no, war is war. I am not fighting for money. It is a question of, I want to make Alexandria. Entire world should be one world, bigger vision. And believe me, in that war also, it's called Alexander, war called Gaugamala, he won the battle. Even today, go to Google and type Gaugamala, you will come to know what it is. I have a big video film, that is 20 minutes. This is what the casualty numbers, the statistics. See, just imagine the crowd, how they stand. The why is called Gaugamala? Go to Google Map, Google Map. Even today you will find the location. You know why? To stand 10 lakh people to war field, you require that much space, open ground. Only they got that space. There is no river, no mountain here. Issus mein mountain water tha, pehle mein kuch nahi tha. अभी तीसरा में देख लो, जस्ट गो टू गूगल एंड चेक इट आउट हाउ द वॉर हैपेंड, हाउ ही मेड इट. आई हैव 20 मिनट्स वीडियो फिल्म, बट ऑलमोस्ट अनदर 10 मिनट्स फॉर लेक्चर इज गेटिंग ओवर. दिस इज द वे ही अटैक. सॉरी, सो लेट मी सी, दिस इज हाउ यू गेट इट इन गूगल सर, नॉट माइन. आई आल्सो डाउनलोडेड एंड ब्रॉट, सो आई डोंट वांट टू टेक अथॉरिटी, बट यू नो बिफोर दिस 331. The earlier was 333, 3 years, 2 years gap. This is one of historical work. Go to Google, you'll come to know how the crowd was standing. There's a real video thing. Go to YouTube and type Gaugamala war, you will get it. In fact, war strategy is the one word derived from war. That's what I want to say. Every war they treated as a strategy. Probably he was setting the authority on it. Chanakya is a great principal strategist. Chanakya is a strategist, not a Chandragupta. And whatever strategy they used in the wars are more. That's why we used to say, war happened for three reasons, but none of the time Alexander fought for this. If you see the moral quality, ethics, values, Alexander always rated best. I like to tell you what is the purpose of doing business. According to me, I had one of the conference, I was there, I was against apple bread. Somebody asked the question, I was there with Nilesha. One of the conferences I met Paribai. We are discussing the same point. I said, what Apple is doing value? Today if you see the sale of the Apple in India is lost, you know that? Even Samsung sale is lost because of demonetization. One of the largest selling mobile in India is Redmi. MI. One of the largest selling mobile. You know the reason why? That product has some extent. Because of that, even Micromax, Carbon lost the market share. Today is India's largest selling brand. 11,000 rupees the mobile what you get, better than Apple. And today corporates are appreciating it. Why Apple is the company? Anybody in the world today, if you talk about business school, highly discussed topic is Apple. You know why? Highly innovative product in last century. What innovation they have done? If you say you are a highly innovative company, as a strategist, what we question for it? You are innovative, tell me how much money you spend R&D. What is your success ratio? How many patent you got? How many innovation you have done? What is your size of the R&D team? Is it right? No. If you say you are a best college, means what will you ask? What are the parameters? Tell me the placement, what are the number of students, what are the quality of faculty, what are the infrastructure, right or wrong? These are the parameters will justify you are highly XYZ. If Apple is a highly innovative company, where do they rank in the global picture? That's when it differentiates from the crowd. How best students we are, business school students. Layman tell you, Apple is the great product. If you come to me, I will argue. You tell me what is the proof. I can tell you with the numbers. How much money they invested in R&D? The best investors who spend money on R&D, Xerox. Not Apple. Epson. But we don't know, Epson is a dark matter printer. And if those guys really invented money, they take. Apple is very good at, you know what? Execution. They will invent, I will took that and I will make it into commercial, I will make a money. That means you are a great company. Everybody knows, see, from employees' perspective, they are not great. Chalo from the investor side, go and compare. I can't compare with Apple with HDFC. Sorry to say this. I can't compare, both are different. But tell me, if you invest 100 rupees in Apple, 100 rupees in HDFC, yet after what I look as investor, how much money I got back? Apple never invested into the shareholders. Whoever invested, they never got money till. Go to the history and check it out. That percentage, how much they give back. HDFC, according to that, even if you did 100 rupees, you got 40 rupees back. Apple is a world-class company, the investors never got the money. Chalo, investor bhi paisa nahi mila, employee ke bhi customer ka dekho, tisra stakeholder. Everybody knows bullshit product, 70-80,000 rupees. Real product, not even 40,000 rupees. Customer also exploited. Is it a great product? Customers are the chosen. Who is the fifth stakeholder? Government. How much tax paid Apple to produce from the US? How much country benefited? Check it out. OB nahi. Then what are you talking about bullshit? Then what is the purpose of doing business? See, this is what the question is all about. I started with the lecture. Maybe I said one side Chanda Kochar and Bhattacharya Madam. See, I can't compare. But you will see which as a country we are all thought process leaders. Tomorrow you are going to make nothing great about it. I will charge 10 rupees product and 100 rupees and I make 80 rupees profit. That any government dickery beggar can do. Keeping a low price product into premium price and make money out of it. If you are any great strategic guy, 10 rupees product make it to 8 rupees, still you make profit. That is challenge. Again I repeat, that is what the role of strategy comes. And that's why today Indian companies are reinventing themselves. How they gone into value for many, not for money. Probably that another area of what I am going to discuss, write it down. Value for money, everybody can talk. India can talk for value for many.
Britannia, Tiger Biscuit.
Whatever you can say, all Indian companies are best into this. We are not value for money, we are very value conscious customers. That's what the Indian companies towards global. Today you pay the fees, you the knowledge what you get is better than Harvard. This is what Indian companies can add value to you. Is it something great? Charging premium price, saying that customer has to bear? What is it here? Nano Academy is a great product.
Yes.
See how the pricing is worked out. Nobody in the world can tell. Everybody pricing work out, basic cost, operation cost, production cost, marketing, branding, the price goes to 2 to 3 lakhs. But Ratan Tata never did that. He said, I make 1 lakh, I want this product because they want backward integration to make a product with this. Anyway, they lost, that is different. But that is one of the highly innovative products in the world. According to me, Nano is best product than Apple. एक लाख आप देखो पूरा गाड़ी देते हैं आप तमा छोटा मोबाइल देख के 80,000 लेते हैं इसी तरह बिजनेस नो सर पेनफुल सर सी दिस इज थॉट प्रोसेस मैन पावर बिहाइंड व्हाट इट हैपेंस इफ यू आर अ कंपनी कैन यू एबल टू क्रिएट दैट एंटायर वर्ल्ड लॉक्ड इट स्टिल नथिंग टू अप्रूव इट सब वे विल ट्रॉन दैट इज डिफरेंट वी विल डिस्कस सम अदर टाइम वेरी विल कम But according to me, strategy as well as that's what I said, no? Business is all about purpose here. Strategic leadership. Why Alexander became a great leader? Because he knows, even though he has a brain, he took Aristotle as a mentor. And he not only fought with brains, he also fought with value sentiments. You have seen that clip, right? And believe me, I'll show one more slide, you can able to understand that. You, classic it is. It's a self-explanatory slides. He also did innovation, technology and all, right? What are the Alexander great leadership if you talk about? There are many points. His father himself is a Philip. Highly innovation is done in Gaugamala. They created new artilleries, right? And Philip is a great, his father. But you see why this world, this is highlighted, you know? Why Alexander as a great strategist and leader? You also said, we never called Genghis Khan as a great warrior. We never called Napoleon as a great warrior. World has many history, many warriors in the world. Please remember guys. When I called you Alexander, everybody said great. I never said. Why you said? There must be some genuine effort behind them. This guy never fought for money. Please remember. And he always stand front of the battle. He never lived. He, good leaders always stand from the front. Whether it's a Lagandu Renado or a Dangal Renado. Good movies, good leadership, stand from friend, right? And you can talk about he was natural leader with loyalty. In fact, he's the only one leader at that time. Whatever he earned money, he has to equally share with everyone. Alexander has the quality. Read the book, you'll get it. In fact, after his death also people used to say, he said, please keep my hand open, everybody should know I've not carried anything, even though I won one entire battle in the world. After death, I had nothing. Alexander's hand was above the ground. That is the beauty of our history. Yet after he died, at the early age 32, but he was active in the war for not even 15 years. But within 15 years he achieved. What are the beauty of the birth? You see all great successful leaders dies at early, because the purpose of the birth is achieved. Whether it's the Jesus or Christ or Vivekananda or Shankaracharya. All people die early 30s. Because the purpose is changed, even if they stay another 10 years, they may not be achieved, but still people remember Vivekananda. Because that is a great property of the soul. See that how this guy has done. He shared equally with the employees, wealth with the employees. He defeated the leader, allowed to take the kingdoms. He won forest. But he never burned the city of Bihar. He said after winning the battle, he said you only ran into vision. But remember I am the king. See that's a great point. No rebellions. And nobody never compelled his army to join in his force. Whoever fought with Alexander's team, they took on his passion. You can't make it compulsory. That onus is a one point where you can discuss as a separate topic for discussion. That is one of the great things. And these are the things what he has done as a great prize with that. What Alexander has done with the prize, what is all about lady, technology. You go to Gaugamala War in YouTube, you will come to know whatever I said. These are all the things you will find it in Gaugamala War. I told you the PPT also. This is what the Gaugamala War is all about. This is what the numbers, casualties, still you won the battle. So please remember, I like to conclude strategies all about. Size doesn't matter. If you have a great strategy, if you have a good resource, if you know how to utilize, today Apple replaced with Sony. Inconvenient truth, right? The shuffle can store 2400 songs. Examine me better at the better. Aaj ka jarurat nahi. Remember the monkeys. You don't need to be tiger. Take a Patanjali, it's like a monkey. Nirma is like a monkey. They are not HLL or PhD. But still, Baba Ramdev, maybe Balakrishna can able to compete anyone. Right? You don't need to be Harvard. Even with it here, if you do right strategy, you can compete Harvard. Thank you.
conversation?
Yes.
I have to check out his time. I'm sure it will give you an insight about what he's been doing, wonderful work. And you know, one of the things which probably the style of education came from India but went abroad was a case study approach. What is case study? Nothing but you know, stories to be told. In India, the strategy kahani ke through hi bataya gaya. So I think he's mastered the art and I'm very impressed. My request that can you keep the PPT?
I can.
Yes.
Maybe I'll see in March because February I'm traveling.
Yeah.
Two lectures weekend with IIM Indore, two lectures going out of country, Dubai and all. I told him yesterday, he said, sir, tomorrow I can come because I committed. Today also morning I completed 1 hour lecture and came with Vivekananda Chembur. Definitely I'll come, it's my pleasure because touch wood, I always say, you know, money is not everything, God has given me at many stages. Certain things if we could able to carry, because he is doing genuine work. The course what he is doing, I still feel, sir, my request and suggestion, this course has a huge potential. Only thing, Alexander also the same example, the thumb rule for Alexander, I have not mentioned it, sorry, here. One of the great point is speed. And today's business, you should be a very speed, so that people, today there is no word called core competence under, because anybody can copy anything. Maybe the copying it takes 6 months, 1 year. By that time, we should go faster so that people can't do that. People bound to copy. Tomorrow, somebody will start this course. With the Indian value system, nobody can take, I am the authority on it. Tomorrow, some other religious group will start. Probably they will get much more advantage than Mumbai University. For example, today, tomorrow, Baba Rabde starts Institute University on value ethics. He can go 10 times higher than us. Remember that. You can't tell him this is ours value. Anybody can take system values. How speed we can go fast, only Achyendu survived. Alexander also one of the great warriors because he used to act very tactically. Dhoni also very good, that's why he's become a best captain. He created wonderful tactics, confusion, even nobody could thought. For example, T20, you take any winning match. Nobody could thought last over can be centered by Joginder. Even Joginder himself doesn't know whether he will be bowling last over. No, that is the beauty. You know why? Opponent knows, the Pakistani knows, if the Sardar bowls, Harbhajan, they know how to act because they already seen how Harbhajan bowls. Everybody knows. Why he selected Joginder? He himself doesn't know how to bowl. Forget about how others know. Am I right?
Yeah.
And finally what happened, Misbah gave the catch to Srisan. Please remember, go anywhere in the world, one corner there is a Madhu. So remember, anywhere there is a Madhu will be there. Right? Okay, thanks a lot guys, I really enjoyed.
I used to rush for a lecture immediately, I was telling him lunch clear on the day, but the next time we will reach.
So this PPT is in desktop. Good luck, I am there in LinkedIn, not in Facebook. I am there in Facebook, but if you want, you can connect me in LinkedIn. Dr. Srinivas.
Thank you,
sir.
Before I forget, he's been also guiding a lot of PhD students in the field of management and leadership. So if you can also come back later on to share some experiences on PhD and the research methodologies, this is more of the session. By the way, he is one of the youngest PhD guides in Mumbai University with a very, very good record for his students. Would you like to share one or two lines about that before we
part? Okay, I'm one of the management, almost Bombay DC has only 24 gates in their management. I'm one of the, not only one. And normally people used to say, every day, I'm sure if I show my mobile right now and I go back, there'll be minimum 5-10 missed calls. Most of them are for PhD inquiries, because with me, PhD will happen in 3.5 years. Because I teach them speed. If I don't practice it in me, then there is no doesn't mix. Preacher is different, teacher is different. Then if you want to preach only, then I should be a preacher, no, not a teacher. The reason is speed is one thing. So I complete my PhD students without compromising quality, some extent. Good publication. Almost today I completed. This month I am getting another 5. 6 PhDs are getting over from my guidance. And Bombay University, we are having a PhD center. I still head the Vivekananda Center PhD. And now probably JB I'll take the students. PhD is a one area where it will give definitely good legacy. And one great thing, you're all doing wonderful course. When I say wonderful course, there are two contents. One is the delivery course content, deliverable marketability. And another one is when I said sometimes there will be a recognition quality content may not be acceptability. Whereas if you do from Mumbai industry logo, even tomorrow if you travel abroad, if you want to do further studies, nobody will say you this course is not recognized. Assume even if you do MBA from IIPM or some institutes where they charge 15 lakhs with international tour, but market never accept. So definitely you are, my only suggestion, you don't need to regret or anything, no second thrust. And course doesn't add value, please remember, you have to add value to the course.
Yeah. Excellent.
And whatever you can do, because you are going to be the brand ambassador, the course performance will depend upon you guys. Always first mover will have advantage. I always used to tell in long run, first mover get never advantage in long run. But first mover students definitely will get advantage. Flexibility in subject, attendance, workload, peer pressure, passing. Right? So definitely you are having advantage as far as the first mover is. But the course has huge potential. Take it seriously and I'm sure you can try to come with new innovation. I know personally Radha when he was doing PhD days. I invited him when he was 2003 at Thakur Institute.
Yes.
My only request, definitely if you go with new courses, I think he is one of the persons can able to connect with your age. Normally you don't find it in university system. That will take it as advantage, no? That's, university has a weakness on that. But that will take it as a strength. You can connect with it, go with your open mind, new thought process, let him lead. That is his responsibility, how he is going to deliver that, your new process innovation. Try to have something different lectures, drive yourself on your own. Create a team within that, try to do some innovative way of doing the course, getting into explore and try to create. And I don't know your syllabus, but still I saw as well as you said. You are learning all the Indian ethos, values, principle. Unless and if you don't able to connect with today's corporate, doesn't make sense. So if you want to connect with the corporate, you have to, you can't go every company and try to do that. You take this as a platform and try to connect, probably this has much more value.
Sure.
If you don't have to connect with corporate, then it makes sense, you know.
Thank you so much. Thank you. We'll be back at 2:20.
Come on.
Bye-bye. Thank you, sir.